Morning students, today in this module we will discuss about Raoult's law. Before going to the details of Raoult's law, let us revise what is the meaning of vapor pressure and what is the qualitative effect of adding two components to make a solution. So let us first understand the concept of vapor pressure. Dear students, when any liquid is taken in a closed system, this is a closed system. And in this system, any liquid is taken, then two opposing tendencies, they operate at the same time. Liquid changes to its vapor state. The process is called evaporation. And vapors, they changes to their liquid state. This process is called condensation. And when equilibrium is achieved, rate of condensation and rate of evaporation, both of them becomes equal. And at this equilibrium state, number of molecules that are present in liquid state, number of molecules that are present in vapor state, both of them becomes constant. And at the point of this equilibrium, pressure exerted by the liquid vapors at the surface of liquid is called its vapor pressure. So this is a closed system in which a liquid is taken. At any given instance, liquid changes to its vapors and vapors, they changes to their liquid state. Then at equilibrium, rate of evaporation becomes equal to rate of condensation, and at the stage of this equilibrium, pressure exerted by the vapors of liquid at the surface of liquid is called as vapor pressure of this liquid. So vapor pressure is defined as pressure exerted by vapors of a liquid at the surface of liquid when both of them are present in equilibrium with each other at a constant temperature. So that is what is called vapor pressure. Now, if this is a mixture of two liquids, then what would happen? Say for example, this contains a liquid A as well as it also contains another liquid B, and both of them are volatile, means both of them, they evaporates to their vapor state. So when both the liquids are present in a closed system, both of them will evaporate, and vapors of individual liquid have got their individual pressures, which are called as partial pressure. So the pressure generated by the molecules of liquid A is called as partial pressure of B, and pressure created by molecules of liquid B is called as partial pressure of B. And in most of the cases it happens that the combined pressure exerted by liquid A and liquid B is generally more than the any of individual components that would have exerted. So in most of the cases it is observed that when two liquids are mixed and a solution is made, then resulting vapor pressure is more than individual components. Now what happens when we add a non-volatile solute to it? Addition of non-volatile solute causes lowering in vapor pressure of pure solvent. Say for example, this is pure solvent having a vapor pressure of P0. Then a non-volatile solute is added. Non-volatile solute is added to it and a solution is formed. With the vapor pressure PS. And it is observed that this vapor pressure PS is always less in comparison to that of P0. PS is always less than P0. Means when a non-volatile solute is added to any pure solvent and solution is formed, solution has got a lower vapor pressure in comparison to that of pure solvent. So this is called as lowering of vapor pressure. And why addition of a non-volatile solute causes lowering of vapor pressure? When pure solvent is taken, at the surface of liquid only particles of solvent are present, and once this non-volatile solute is added and solution is formed, then apart from particles of solute particles are also present which are non-volatile. So here this entire area is covered by solvent particles only, and total area available for the evaporation of solvent particles is more molecules are present in vapor phase, hence a greater vapor pressure is observed. But once non-volatile solute is added, then some of the places are also occupied by the particles of solute which is non-volatile, which is not going to convert in the vapor phase. So because of presence of particles or molecules of this non-volatile solute at the surface, total surface area available for the evaporation of solvent particles is reduced, because of which less molecules are present in vapor phase and vapor pressure is also reduced. So, in a nutshell, we can combine all these observations in three lines. First, vapor pressure is defined as the pressure exerted by vapors of a liquid at the surface of liquid when this liquid phase and vapor phase of same liquid, they are present in equilibrium with each other at constant temperature. Number two, when two volatile liquids are added together, in most of the cases resulting vapor pressure is higher in comparison to that of vapor pressure of individual components. Third, when any non-volatile solute is added to a pure solvent, then vapor pressure of solution is always less than the vapor pressure of pure solvent. And this decrease in the vapor pressure is called as lowering of vapor pressure. Now Raoult was a French scientist, F.M. Raoult's, correlated F.M. Raoult correlated the partial pressure of a component in solution phase and its amount in the solution. So let us understand Raoult's law. Say for example, here we have one component A with a vapor pressure P0A, and this is another component B with a vapor pressure P0B. Both of them are mixed to make a solution where partial pressure of component A is represented by PA and partial pressure of component B is represented by, this is solution, is represented by PB. And mole fraction in the solution is given by X of A and X of B. So according to Raoult's law, partial pressure, and this for this entire system T remains constant. So for this system, Raoult's law says that partial pressure of component A is given by the product of its vapor pressure in pure state and its mole fraction in solution phase. Similarly, partial pressure of component B is given by its vapor pressure in pure state and its mole fraction in the solution. So this is what is called as Raoult's law. Raoult's law ये कहता है कि अगर हम किन्हीं दो volatile components को मिला करके एक solution बनाते हैं, तो solution phase में किसी भी component का partial pressure, pure state में उसके vapor pressure और solution में उसके mole fraction के product के बराबर होता है, जबकि दूसरे component का partial pressure So this is about Raoult's law. Now according to Raoult's law, PA is given by P0A into XA, PB is given by P naught B into X of B, and according to Dalton's law of partial pressures, total vapor pressure PS is given by PA plus PB. So it is given by P naught A into XA plus P naught B into XB, or P naught A into XA plus P naught B 1 minus X of B. So this is one minus X of A. So this can be written as P naught A into XA plus P naught B minus P naught B XA. So here we will take XA as common, will give you P naught A minus P naught B plus P naught B. Or it could be written like this, PS is given by P naught A minus P naught B XA plus P naught B Y is equal to MX plus C. So this equation can be correlated to the equation of a straight line Y is equal to MX plus C, which implies that when PS is plotted against X of A, it should be a straight line. So that is how we can validate Raoult's law, and that is the actual case also. In actual practice also, we observe the same thing. Now, let us consider a solution that is made by mixing two components A and B, where B is non-volatile. That means a solid is mixed in a liquid to make the solution. So in this case, according to Raoult's law, PA is given by P naught A into XA and PB is equal to 0. Why? Because this component B is non-volatile. So since it will not go in vapor phase, so it will not have any vapor pressure also. And total vapor pressure PS will become equal to P naught A into XA. So this can be rewritten as PS upon P naught minus X of A. And once deduct both sides from 1. Deduct both sides from 1. So it will happen 1 minus PS upon P naught is equal to 1 minus X of A, or it is P naught minus PS upon P naught is equal to X of B, and this is called as relative lowering of vapor pressure.
So this is Raoult's law for a non-volatile solute, which says that relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to mole fraction of solute in the solution. Now, Raoult's law is a special case of Henry's law. According to Henry law, PA is given as KH into
xA, or we can say pA is directly proportional to xA. According to Raoult's law, pA is equal to P naught A into xA, and since this value is constant at a constant temperature, then pA is directly proportional to xA. So whether it is Henry's law or it is Raoult's law,
both of the cases statement comes same. Partial pressure of component is directly proportional to its mole fraction in the solution. Thereby we say that Raoult's law is a special case of Henry's law. So I am quite sure that you are able to understand the concept of Raoult's law. Raoult's law correlate the partial pressure of the component to its mole fraction in the solution. Thank you.